Hello everyone. Today's video is about a topic that was requested, teething. And you know, I talk about this topic all the time. The reason we talk about it a lot is because it can really wreak havoc in the babies and therefore the parents' lives. So what can happen when a baby is teething? They can become more irritable, cranky, have difficulty falling asleep, have difficulty staying asleep, cry out as if in pain, because they probably are. They can sometimes refuse their bottle or have difficulty nursing because they just want to clamp down and gnaw on things. And it just makes them really in a bad mood, which can hurt your day too. So other things that can happen, we don't believe that true fever comes from teething. A lot of parents think, oh, the baby was 102, but they're teething, so it was just the teething. No, my rule of thumb is if the temperature is anything above 100, it's probably more than teething. Now, why would they even have low grade temp? That's debatable, but I could buy maybe that this is such an inflammatory process that it increased the basal temperature, maybe. So maybe low grade I could blame on teething, but certainly nothing over 100 would you blame on that. Now here's the problem. A lot of parents will tell you that every time their baby's teething, they also get sick. So they attribute the illness to the teething. And that's not really the case either. Personal theory here is that just that teething baby puts everything into their mouth. So probably they just were more likely to catch something that they had touched and went into their mouth. Same story with diarrhea. A lot of parents say that their baby always has diarrhea when they're teething. Maybe, or maybe they just caught a couple of random viral episodes of gastroenteritis from putting everything into their mouth. Who knows? So that's possible. Other things that we see all the time with teething is it hurts more to lay flat at night. So let's say you're placing the baby down, you're laying it down into the crib, and the baby screams out. So a lot of people assume that's an ear infection, and it certainly could be, particularly with a true fever, or if there had been a lot of nasal congestion, runny nose, cough associated with that. But a lot of times it could be teething as well. These two things, teething and ear infections, are very simple to mix up because a lot of teething babies do pull on their ears. Turns out babies under a year old with ear tugging, that's not a very accurate predictor of whether or not they have an ear infection. Babies get referred pain, so if their gums are inflamed, they easily get that pain referred to their ears and then they'll mess with their ears a lot. So you may notice with your baby just an increase in crankiness, increase in drooling, and an increase in putting everything into their mouth, and probably that's just teething even if they complain when you try to place them flat into the crib. So that leads us to one good trick is you could try to elevate their heads in the crib, not with a pillow, certainly, especially if they're under 1 year of age, but with a rolled up quilt or towel under the mattress so that the mattress is elevated, or with a wedge, a safe wedge device. So let's talk about other things. You could try to massage their little gums with clean fingers. Once the teeth erupt though, you definitely don't want them chewing or gnawing on your knuckle. Those first little teeth are extremely sharp. So you could try massage, you could try cold things. You could take teething rings and stick them in the refrigerator or even the freezer and let them gnaw on them. Frozen banana, frozen bagel, same sort of idea. Just let them gnaw on them to massage their gums. You can use under 6 months Tylenol, and then 6 months and above Tylenol or ibuprofen. And probably ibuprofen is even better. The dentists tell us that teeth move more at night, so they probably actually experience more pain overnight. And you know, the half-life of ibuprofen is longer than that of Tylenol. So if you wanted to do, not forever and not every single night, but for particularly bad nights, if you wanted to do a dose of ibuprofen at bedtime, that would be perfectly appropriate to help everyone get a little bit more rest if it could relieve the baby's pain. So let me tell you about teething. On average, the first teeth are the lower gum, middle two, and then the upper gum, middle two, and then side, 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 side. Then they skip a space for the canines, and around 15 months do the back, all four back molars, then come back in and fill in that slot, the canines, and then around two, there are two-year molars, and then around five, there are five-year molars. So on average, the first tooth to erupt is around 6 months, but there's a huge variation, and I don't want you to be worried if your baby is a little delayed with their first and subsequent tooth eruptions, because it's actually good, the dentists say, for the teeth to be in the gum tissue, because that way it's not exposed to sugar or calories or milk or anything that's gonna cause decay of those teeth, so they're just generally protected in the gum tissue. Now, once the teeth do erupt, you can just wipe it off at bedtime with a little warm, wet washcloth. The American Academy of Pediatrics does recommend that children begin to see a pediatric dentist by 12 months, and that you are brushing, if teeth are present there, twice a day, goal of 2 whole minutes. Sometimes that's hard to do, but that's the goal, twice a day, 2 whole minutes. And we do recommend that you use a kid's fluoridated toothpaste. Here's the deal. Until that child can spit on purpose, which is on average around 3 years of age, you only want to do this tiniest smear on the bristles. You barely touch the bristles of the baby toothbrush to the toothpaste. We're talking like half of a grain of rice amount of toothpaste because we know the baby's going to swallow it. But we do want the fluoride because the fluoride mineralizes the enamel of the tooth and strengthens it, making it more impervious to attack from bacteria and acidic conditions that can lead to cavities. So yes, you can use kids fluoride toothpaste. So it's confusing because when you go to the toothpaste aisle, there are baby toothpastes, say fluoride free. And I get what they're saying, but we actually want the fluoride. The problem is we don't want you to leave this toothpaste, a very yummy, bizarre tasting like bubblegum flavored toothpaste, down where the child can reach it because it does taste good and they can eat all of it. And if the baby consumes too much fluoride, it can ironically cause some discoloration of the enamel called fluorosis. So we don't want them getting too much, but we do want a tiny little dose every single day. So I think we've covered everything that I wanted to. Teething doesn't actually make them sick. It just can get them exposed to more germs. It is safe to use ibuprofen or Tylenol. Ibuprofen probably the better choice at bedtime. And then we went through the typical eruption. On average, 6 months, bottom, top, side, molars, then canines. And this was requested, so I hope for you who requested this that this has been helpful and helpful for others as well. If you have additional ideas or questions, please let me know and I can do a video on that topic. Thanks.